several of our videos have been demonetized after human review by YouTube representatives, which is why we emphasize that our videos are 100% educational, are not intended to glorify or promote the use of any substance, and strictly fall into the category of videos suitable for monetization according to YouTube policies, under these specific sections. Please don't demonetize our videos, they take a lot of effort, money, study, and dedication to make. According to the OMS, 2.5% of the human population consumes marijuana in some of its forms. This means that more than 200 million people smoke weed or eat marijuana-infused food. According to a study published in 2020 where the reason for consumption was studied in 9,000 people, the majority of those surveyed reported using marijuana to deal with their anxiety. Other popular responses include insomnia, chronic pain, and depression. Stay until the end to learn the whole truth about using cannabis to treat anxiety, depression, and insomnia. In order to be responsible with our response, it is necessary to give you a little class on marijuana. The marijuana plant has two main subspecies, cannabis indica and cannabis sativa. They have different physical compositions, but this is not what matters to most people. What matters most is the difference in the chemical composition of your flower, which determines the main effects it will have on your body and mind when consuming it. Marijuana has more than 426 chemical substances, of which 60 are cannabinoids. However, there are only two of these cannabinoids that really interest us at this moment, CBD or cannabidiol, and THC or tetrahydrocannabinol. With current technology, it is easy to cultivate plants with genetic characteristics, which express exactly the ratio of CBD and THC, determined by the grower according to the function he intends for his plant. To understand this concept more easily, we can use beer production as an example. There are beers with different colors, flavors, and alcohol content depending on the objective of their producer. This may use different types of barley and ingredients in order to provide the experience that consumers expect from their beer with their product. The same can be done with marijuana. For example, CBD has been shown to have anxiolytic properties, meaning it decreases anxiety in people who consume it in controlled studies. On the other hand, THC has anxiogenic properties, which means that it generates anxiety. When administered together, CBD can counteract the anxiogenic properties of THC and render it less anxiety-producing. However, the concentration of THC that we see in marijuana flowers today is exaggeratedly high, and the effects of THC outweigh those of CBD in most cases, making the positive effects of CBD irrelevant and the negative effects of THC prevailing. Let's compare these two substances. THC is responsible for the muscle relaxation felt when using marijuana, the tingling in the extremities, the generalized feeling of pleasure, the giggly mood, the distorted feeling of how time flies, and the brainstorming that suddenly comes to mind. However, it is also responsible for generating anxiety, short-term memory problems, increased heart rate, increased blood pressure, and the feeling of paranoia and occasional psychosis. CBD, on the other hand, does not generate the psychotropic effects of THC, but it is anti-inflammatory, modulates the immune system, is anticonvulsant, reduces anxiety, is antipsychotic, has neuroprotective antioxidants, and possibly can contribute positively towards the treatment of chronic diseases, such as cancer and diabetes. As we mentioned before, the marijuana that is currently found in countries without regulations has such high THC concentrations and such low CBD concentrations that the medium and long-term effects of active marijuana smokers are harmful to their mental health. A study carried out on 120 people, of whom 66 smoked marijuana daily, and 54 did so recreationally, showed that those with higher THC concentrations in their hair samples suffered more from anxiety and depression and had worse memory than those with lower concentrations of THC in their hair. Those with higher concentrations of CBD in their hair samples had fewer symptoms of psychosis and significantly better memory than their counterparts. A significant association has also been shown against marijuana use and the development of mental illnesses such as schizophrenia and bipolar affective disorder. The people most vulnerable to developing these conditions are those who consume marijuana with high THC concentrations and low CBD concentrations, have a relative with any of these diseases, have a genetic predisposition, or have a schizotypal personality disorder, among other factors. You can identify if you have a schizotypal personality disorder and therefore a higher risk of developing these diseases if you use marijuana, and you have difficulty establishing close relationships outside of your immediate family circle if you have flat emotions or your emotional responses are usually limited or inappropriate, persistent and excessive social anxiety, eccentric or strange thoughts, strange speaking or illogical ramblings during conversations, belief in special powers, such as telepathy or superstitions, wearing oddly matching clothes. To give an objective answer to the question of whether marijuana works to treat your anxiety, even if you do not have a schizotypal personality, it is most likely very bad for this purpose. It may even be responsible for your anxiety. However, things could be very different if some things change in the face of regulation, your consumption habits, and market conditions. We'll talk about this in a moment. First, we want you to understand why it is most likely a very bad idea to use marijuana to treat your anxiety at this time. Even if you feel a relaxed state while using, you will most likely feel anxious when you stop consuming, causing you to use to feel calm again. Remember that the marijuana you consume has very high concentrations of THC and very low concentrations of CBD. This creates a vicious cycle that makes you think that marijuana helps you control your anxiety, when in fact marijuana might be responsible for your anxiety. You think it helps you, but in reality you just feel temporary calm from the effects of THC. Your body and mind become dependent, and you need more and more to reach that state of tranquility. It is very likely that you think that you can stop consuming whenever you want, that you are in control. If you consume regularly, we challenge you not to consume for a week and tell us about your experience in the comments. We can bet you'll go into withdrawal. Marijuana withdrawal syndrome is real. It involves some of the following: mood swings, irritability, feeling unwell, insomnia, stress, depression, high anxiety, desire to smoke again, and decreased appetite, among others. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, you are most likely addicted to marijuana and need professional intervention to help you overcome it. Now, if marijuana was legal in every country and state, and its consumption and production were regulated, the story would be different. Producers could create flowering strains that contain high levels of CBD and low levels of THC. There would be competition in the market and a wide variety of options for consumers, creating the necessary conditions to reduce the risk of mental illness when consuming marijuana, and even to study its benefits for managing anxiety. The same thing happens for insomnia. We understand that smoking weed before bed can help you fall asleep almost immediately. However, it is very likely that if you stop smoking, your insomnia will worsen, making you dependent on marijuana to sleep. We recommend that you watch our video on insomnia, where you will learn 8 tips that will help you fall asleep very easily and naturally. Find it in the top right corner of this video. For now, and while the production of marijuana is not regulated in your state or country, we recommend that you do not make a habit of its consumption. We recommend you watch our video on the 5 golden rules before using marijuana. You can find it in the upper corner of this video or in the description section. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and leave a comment if you learned something new. At Tuvi Digital, we have a large number of videos like this. Below you will find some that may interest you. Thank you for your time. See you in the next one. A hug.